Yes, it is 43 after the hour. Welcome back to Catholic Answers Live. Let's go straight to your calls and say hi to Renee in Hanover, PA, listening on EWTN Sirius Satellite Radio. Hi, Renee.
Hi, thanks for taking my call.
Our pleasure.
My question touches again on the binding and loosing of sins and maybe a little bit on the infallibility of the Pope.
Okay.
And my question is, throughout history, there have been occasions where the Pope or the Church has excommunicated someone, and, you know, years later they recant and admit that they were wrong. For instance, they excommunicated for not believing that the world was flat.
They never did that. I think you may be thinking of the Galileo case, where was excommunicated for holding that the sun is the center of the universe, not just the solar system, but the whole universe.
You're correct.
And that the scriptures are wrong in the language they use in talking about connected matters.
So what would have happened to the soul of the person that while he was excommunicated?
Okay. Excommunication does not send somebody to hell. The Pope does not have the ability to send somebody to hell. What excommunication does is it warns the person that they have done something very grave that they need to repent of. Now, if that's true, then, you know, it helps wake them up to the fact that they need to repent and they need to seek reunion with God. In the case of a misjudgment on the part of either the Pope or a local bishop, because local bishops can also excommunicate, then if a person is innocently excommunicated for some reason, God knows that. And he's not going to deny the person salvation on the basis of an innocent, on the basis of a mistaken excommunication. So if the person's otherwise in a state of grace, being excommunicated doesn't take you out of the state of grace. The person still has sanctifying grace in his soul, and unless he commits some other mortal sin, the person will go to heaven. In terms of infallibility, which you mentioned, the Church does not claim that infallibility extends to administrative acts like excommunication, and consequently, the subject of infallibility isn't engaged here at all. The Church isn't claiming to be infallible in the administration of excommunications. Those are pastoral decisions that are made, and the Church doesn't claim that it's infallible in matters of pastoral judgment.
So do those principles apply as well to the binding and loosing of sins?
Well, insofar as the binding and loosing of sins it corresponds with them, yes. Obviously, if someone has been denied absolution, through no fault of their own, they really have repented, they really have done their best to confess adequately, and for some reason the priest just doesn't absolve them, then the person still has the opportunity of salvation through what's known as perfect contrition. So being denied absolution, which, by the way, is rare, too. If someone comes and says they're sorry, priests take them at their word, unless it's really clear there's something else going on. But if someone were to be wrongly denied absolution, God can still provide for that person's salvation.
Okay, Renee?
Okay, great. Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Thank you much.